So we thank God for that. Amen. And you know, when you think about ministry and help, it goes together. You can't do ministry if you're not healthy in your own body. He wants us to be healthy. He wants us to be robust. And he wants us to be happy Christians. Amen. He certainly can use a strong and healthy Christian far more effectively than he can use a sick, broke, and depressed one. Therefore, take good care of your temple. After continuous ministry for long periods of time, it is absolutely essential that you rest and refresh. Let's see what the Lord's view is about your health and well-being. With some pages here that you really need to study up on. Scriptures, 3 John 1 and 2. Beloved, I will above all things that you may prosper and be in good health, the same way your mind prospers in the knowledge of his good will. Now, I know we're all over the age of 21, and when it comes to our health, many times we put our health on the back burner until a doctor tells us we need to do something. We should not wait until we go to a doctor and hear a doctor tell us that we need to exercise more, we need to eat better. And each of us in here tonight, when you leave, I want you to really think about the food that you consume. Is it really good for your temple? And sometimes we need to make food changes. It's all right to eat all that good stuff, but if you're going to be a couch person and never exercise, never walk, never do anything, you're adding pain to your body, stress to your body, and worry to your mind. So therefore, when we look at this chapter, it says ministry and health. When you're over God's people, they need you to be in tip-top shape. Amen. Because people will come to you with all kinds of concerns and problems and needs. So if you're going around saying, oh, I got a headache, oh, I'm just so tired, I just can't do it, how do you expect those members to look at you? They're going to look at you like you don't believe God for your healing, or you don't trust what you need to do for your own body. If you need to go to the eye doctor, go to the eye doctor. I know when we get a certain age, we don't want to wear no glasses. Honey, put your glasses on. Put them on because it's going to help you see better. I see so many people when I go to functions and they're up to give a presentation or do something, and they'll carry their glasses up in their hand. And then they'll look at the audience and say, oh, let me put my glasses on. I can't see the print. I need to put my glasses on. Well, you should have walked up there with your glasses on.
That's right.
Stop trying to look like you're 20. That's okay, you want to still have the spirit of youth, but put them glasses on, and it'll help you see better. Yeah. But you know, we still don't want to let go that we moving on up the road. So when the doctors tell you exercise, I just tell you walk. Do some jumping jacks in your bedroom. Do something where you're moving that body. And stop eating late at night and going to sleep on that stuff. Stop doing that. I have done so much research about eating and the things that happen to our bodies. And a lot of these illnesses, we can prevent if we would just exercise and drop some weight. But we don't want to do it. We don't want to drink water. I don't like water. I don't want to drink water. Well, water is the lifeline of who you are.
That's right.
You're made of water.
Come on.
So therefore, think about your health. As I shared with you last week, when I didn't know I was a diabetic and I got sick, I bet you don't have to tell me nothing about what I need to eat today. You don't have to tell me nothing about what I should have. And soda is our downfall.
Amen.
Soda has over 45 grams of sugar. I should have brought how much sugar that is in one bottle of soda. And we're consuming it like it's water. That soda is not doing any good for us. When I had to go through the diabetes class, I had to go to the health class to learn how to eat all over again, and they pointed out what we should eat, and I sat there and cringed at the thought that we eat so much stuff that we don't need it. I don't touch a soda anymore. Amen. And I was drinking soda like people drink coffee. Had to have me 2 and 3 sodas every single day. I do not touch a soda. You can't even get me to want a soda. I drink my water, my lemon water, and I go to Sprouts and Whole Foods and get 0 calories little drinks when I just have to have me something that tastes like a soda. I don't eat eggs anymore like I used to. I eat the egg whites. The doctors will tell you the egg whites are healthier for you than eating that whole egg. Now, don't get me wrong. Don't think I don't want me an egg every now and then, but I don't eat it every day.
Amen.
I don't eat it every day. I eat, the doctors told me you can eat anything you want in moderation.
Amen.
Now, how many of us going to sit down at Thanksgiving and Christmas and know that banana pudding, that lamb, and all of the desserts are sitting there looking at us? And we just said, I'm going to go through every last one of them. You can get a little teaspoon and put it in your mouth and say, it tastes so good, and leave it alone. But how many of us would go get a sliver of that sweet potato pie? Just a sliver. Not the whole slice now. And not the whole pie in. Just a sliver. And then you eat a little bit of it and watch the weight will come off. Some of us got to eat our red meat, and it's okay for you. That's what you got to do. I don't touch it. Turkey burgers. Breakfast is turkey. I used to love me some bacon. Love it. I will not eat it anymore. Because what I learned with health, under ministry and health, I want to be here as long as my daddy God says I have. I don't want to rush myself out of here because I am not eating the way I should eat. And drinking the water that I should drink. And exercising. When I went to the doctor on Tuesday, they wanted me to come back because my pressure was going up and down. My pressure was fine on Tuesday. And I told the doctor, I know what it was from. I exercised more this week. I drank more water this week. And I kept away from them foods I know I shouldn't have. If you're going to say you're God's man or woman, then follow all the laws of the land when it comes to your health. Don't just pick what you want to pick and say, oh, God, that doctor really don't know what he's talking about. Too many of our people are getting stage 4 cancer. And then they say, oh, my God, I got stage 4 cancer. What happened? Because you didn't do what the doctor told you to do. We know we serve the God of all gods, who's in control of everything. But I'm telling you, you will see your weight come off of you if you just tell yourself that, Lord, I want to be your servant, but I want to be a healthy servant. I want to do what you want me to do, but I want to do it. And then on in the chapter, it tells us, it's right here in the book. She has it right here how we should eat. They told me I'm supposed to have 3 small meals and have my snacks. We don't want to get a little bit. We want the whole plate to be full when we sit down at the table. That's too much food. They told us if our food is over our fist, that's too much food. Too much food. And we think we got to have all that food. When your stomach starts to protrude and you big around here, that means food is not being digested through your body properly. Some people got food inside of them 10, 15 years ago. Because your body is not digesting it correctly. And then the food starts to go onto the walls of your stomach. That's why some people get a colonics, where they go in and they put the tube and they clean you out on the inside. And when you get one, if you've never had one, they hook you up to a machine. I've had one. And you see all these little particles going through the machine. And what it is that food that has attached itself to the lining of your stomach. That you wouldn't believe it until you sit there and they actually let you see it, and your food is going. You say, is that inside of me? Been inside of you probably for years. And people won't even pay to get a colonics because they don't want to do that. But I tell you, once you get one, your insides, when you finish, is so clean. You know it's clean. You don't want to eat that stuff. And then it has the most dangerous foods. And you know, it's number one is the soda, the shrimp, the lobster, the artificial sweeteners. And this is another thing I know you don't know. Folks will go get them artificial sweeteners to put in that coffee and whatever else. That stuff got chemicals in it that you don't even need in your body. All you got to do is research it. Everything is online. So all of those artificial sweetness, and then you go buy a frozen TV dinner. Well, I'm going to eat this frozen TV dinner because it's good. And you know this is healthy. But have you read the label? Have you read the label? They taught us that. 1,200 sodium. 500 sodium. That is too much salt. Too much salt. They told me that I use Miss Dash. I go to Whole Foods and get a 7 seasoning thing. I don't do no salt, no nothing. And see, because we don't know it, you got to read the labels. All they teach us is to learn how to read the labels. No more than 15 grams of sugar. No more than 15 grams of carbohydrates. That's it. Anything you see on that label that's over 15 grams, you're taking in too much. So I try to buy things that have 15 grams, and how much sugar is in it. And I don't even buy a frozen dinner anymore. That stuff is bad for you. Got too much sugar, too much sodium in it. But we'll go get them frozen dinners, and please don't go to them fast food places. McDonald's and all of them places, that stuff is just death for you. It's not good for you. Just last week I heard on the news where a young girl was so hooked on a cup of noodles. She's 18 now, and since the age of 13, she just consumed cup of noodles. The baby got cancer.
Wow.
She's sick now. They're saying they're trying to do whatever they need to do to reverse how she's eaten these last couple of years. Because all she wants is a cup of noodles. A cup of noodles is deadly for you.
Yes.
So I know some of you will say, oh my God, that means I can't eat nothing. Yeah, you can eat something. I eat good every day. My fruits, my vegetables, my water. And I just watch what I eat. Because I want to be as strong and healthy for my ministry. I don't want them to have to come see me in the hospital bed because the doctor just said, okay, you got diabetes and you're still not doing right. No. No, I'm going to follow what they tell me to do. See, we have accepted that you got to have cancer. We've accepted that you got to be a diabetic. We've accepted that cancer got to stay in your body. God says he got all the healing in his hand, but he got to see us do something first. We need to shed that weight. We need to get that weight off. Now when I see people overweight, I look at them and say, when are you going to change how you eat?
Hallelujah.
When?
Hallelujah.
When the doctor tells you to do it? No, you should do it because God wants you to do it.
Yeah.
So therefore, when you read this, it's so good, and I'm a health fanatic right now because I know what I went through. See, I know I could have been sleeping in my grave, gone. But God gave me another chance.
Right.
And since he gave me another chance, I'm going to eat right. And I'm going to tell you to eat right. Because you don't play with your health. You don't play when you're in the hospital and they tell you you've been in a coma for 3 days and you didn't even know you were here because you did not eat right. Or you said, well, I'm going to eat whatever I want to eat. I'm gonna keep on eating. You got to leave here with something. I may as well come on and eat my chitlins and my pork. And, okay, keep on. Keep on. So if you say you're in ministry over people, look at the chapter. It has nutrition, exercise, water, sunshine, temperance, air, rest, and trust. And I'm going to end it with, you can't stay up all night and do God's work. You know your body get tired. Take your body to sleep. Take your body to sleep and get some rest. Some people are night owls. Some people are morning people. I know I'm a morning person. I usually would have to get up at 5 and go to work. I wake up at 4 and 4:30. And I don't have to be at work till 7:40. I'm at work every day, maybe 45 minutes early because I don't like rushing. And I have to drive 3 freeways. So I know what I need to do. When you say you're going to go somewhere, you should go calm. Not rushing, not doing the things that you know you should. So read this chapter, and it was a good chapter for me because we are what we eat. And if you want God to do great and wonderful things in your life, we say we want to be obedient to him. We say that he is the King of kings and the Lord of lords. But then you better start eating right. And I'm going to be on you about eating right. You know, because that's something we should do. And our children, stop giving them all that junk. Stop giving them all that candy, because that's why they go into the dentist. That's why too many babies got ADHD.
Uh-oh.
Because we are not feeding our children correctly, and then they want to put your baby on all this medication. I'm not a believer of that medication. ADD can be reversed, and a child can learn to their capacity, but we have to do things to help motivate that child so it comes from the meals we prepare. God bless you.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.